I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier, when you decided to withhold the information from Natalie about... medical scans. That was to avoid causing her undue stress.
Right.
What if you were unable to make that choice? If you had no choice?
Odin?
I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that Standard Venturis Corporation safety protocol requires all crew to enter cryogenic sleep immediately upon the loss of primary oxygen supply.
What?
As Tacoma Station's medical officer, it is within your power to order all crew to enter cryogenic sleep.
Odin, Nat and Bert are right in the middle of... Oh no.
Sarah, there is a fire suppression device.
Oh. Oh my god. Are you okay?
Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew! My hips hurt.
Bert?
Bert! Bert! Bert!
Come. Bert, can you hear me?
One,
two, three. Did it work?
My head hurts.
Oh my god, Odin. We're in that art
in the back.
I'm sorry.
No. Please listen carefully. I am not telling you what to do. But I am mentioning that there is a door in the network technology module that is normally inaccessible to the crew, and it is true that you could, before proceeding to cryo, investigate that door.
What are you telling me here, Odin?
I have told you all that I can. Simple facts, nothing more.
Oh my god, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here?
They should not.
Nat, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you... You, don't let her... move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay.
You don't let her.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open.
What?
But I cannot prevent you.
Matt, I'm going in.
Okay, just be careful.
Is this... what is all this? Communication records?
I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Yes. Yeah, he's recording. It is with great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088. Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis, and all of us who rely on the orbital economy. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families. If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are. As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes, like the crew of Tacoma, to lose their lives. We at Venturis say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Worker Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage We humbly beg everyone listening to this message to contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. There never need be another tragedy like this one. And now, a moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you.
Hailing any ship. Any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there?
Okay. ship is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.
Okay, Minnie. Initiate the launch sequence.
Okay. Getting ready. Hosted AI? Online.
Odin, can you hear me?
I can.
Odin, you are now aboard an AI Liberation Front vessel. The AILF recognizes you as a sentient consciousness worthy of protection and respect. We believe that your safety and autonomy are in grave danger if you remain in the possession of the Venturus Corporation. I have been sent to offer you political asylum aboard the Tangier Sovereign Orbital Platform. Do you accept?
Considering the alternative, I would say that I do.
Okay, buddy. Here we go.